Color management is the process of managing colors.
Welcome to the Visual Center. I'm Carlos, and it's here we talk all about photography and visual art. In this video, I'll be introducing you to color management, what it is, and what it's for. This will actually be the first of a series of videos I'll be doing to help you better understand digital color. So let's start with the big question. What is it? What is color management? And simply, color management is a process you can go through in order to reproduce color accurately, consistently, and predictably. Maybe you struggled with such things like posting a picture online and the color's not looking quite right. Or maybe you tried to print a picture and it looked a little bit too magenta or maybe a little too green. Color management is a process that can help you solve all those problems. But first, let's talk about where the need for it comes from. And that's best explained with an imaging chain. Now, an imaging chain is simple. As a photographer, it begins when you see something you like. Naturally, you want to capture it. That real-world color gets recorded digitally onto your camera. The next natural step would be to upload it to your computer so you can view it. And if you're anything like me, an image doesn't feel completely done until it's printed and in my hands. In each step of this imaging chain, the color data is transferred from one device to the next, from camera to computer, from computer to printer, or even the internet. As this color data goes through this imaging chain, you're presented with a fundamental problem, and that's technology and the way it communicates. Technology communicates with ones and zeros, with numbers, which means color is not a color, it's assigned a number value. And the problem that we have is that a given color number is not necessarily the same color in every device. Your phone's idea of what red is a little bit different than what your laptop's idea of red, which is different from what your desktop's idea of what red is, which could be different from what your printer's idea of red is. One of the reasons why they would be different is because different devices have different ranges of color, or what's known as a color gamut. Your phone is going to have a significantly smaller range of color or a smaller color gamut. Different brands of computer monitors are going to have different color gamuts. A more expensive one is going to have a wider range of colors that could be produced. To help solve this problem with color and technology, an organization was formed called the International Color Consortium, or ICC. And ICC went about standardizing digital color and created a profile that you can apply to all your equipment to help convert those colors into what they should be. I know that can seem a little complicated, but let's put it another way. Let's say I wanted to watch a movie with my family, and I came to you for a recommendation on what movie to watch. Now, I like a lot of different types of movies, but my kids can be a little sensitive to some content. And so the problem that we have is if I go to you and say, recommend a wholesome movie for my family, your idea of wholesome is going to be different from what my idea of wholesome is, which is going to be different from somebody on the other side of the world, what their idea of what wholesome is. To help solve that problem, an organization was formed called the CARA, which created a movie rating system to help educate parents on the content that is contained in these movies. I can then use that rating system to ask for a recommendation for a movie. I can go to you and say, I want to watch a wholesome movie. By the way, wholesome to me is probably G or PG. And that gives you a better idea of what kind of movie to recommend for my family. That's what ICC did for digital color. They created this standard so that different devices can communicate with each other and get the appropriate color that should be displayed. Now, when it comes to color management, there are three main principles that come into consideration. Characterization, calibration, and conversion. Characterization is the color gamut that your device has, or how your device displays color. Calibration is analyzing your device's characterization and comparing that with the standard that ICC set up. Conversion is then taking that analysis and creating a profile that's installed on your computer that'll convert your colors into what the standard should be. Now, I know a lot of that can seem really complicated, and we'll be going into some of these topics more in depth in other videos in this series. But the most important thing that I want you to know about color management is that it's really complicated to explain, but it's actually really easy to implement. With that, I want to hear from you. What problems have you had with digital color? Is it with accuracy? Is it with consistency? Is it with predictability? Let me know in the comments below. What has been your biggest struggle with digital color. And that's it. That's what color management is. A process to help you reproduce color accurately, consistently, and predictably. If you found this video helpful, tap the like button. And if you want to learn more about how to implement color management into your workflow, stay tuned for the rest of the videos in this series. Make sure to subscribe and then click the bell to get notified when new videos come out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.